want to wish a very good morning to everybody. I'm very happy to welcome especially all the NARI workers of the past and present, because of whom all the achievements which you just saw were possible. I would also like to welcome all the well-wishers who are here, as they also contributed greatly to our work, either directly or indirectly. Some of them have been there since my father started NARI in the early 1960s. Earlier we thought that we'll just have a small open house sort of thing where people locally will come and visit and students can see what we have done for last 50 years. But then we got more ambitious and decided that we should have a small program, and the enthusiasm increased many fold after Dr. Marshallkar agreed to grace the occasion. Then we also decided to publish a small souvenir and highlights of our 50 years of safflower research. And Mr. Rahul Kishroji, who is a Bajaj Fellow at NARI, artistically designed both these publications. Also the other Bajaj Fellow, Mr. Shubham Sharma, was instrumental in arranging for the program with all his colleagues, and I also thank him. And we also had one of our interns, Mr. Harishankar, whose small video film you just saw. And this was his first attempt, and I think he has done quite well. So I thank all of them for the successful conduct of this ceremony. Of course, all of us are very thankful to Anil, who has been the driving force behind this ceremony. First, he came up with the idea of the program and then prevailed upon all of us to make it successful. I feel that starting such a private research and development organization in the 1960s and successfully running it for 50 years in itself is a great achievement. I have been fortunate to be a part of NARI for 37 out of these 50 years, and I hope to remain involved till this is 50 years, so maybe 13 more years. As early as I can remember, NARI has always been a part of my life. During the 1960s and 70s, since the institute was right next door to our house and in the same yard, I was aware of everything that was happening there. Even after I went to Pune for college, during the holidays when I visited home, I was either roped in to give a presentation on some scientific article picked out by my mama, Dr. Anand Karve, who was the first director of NARI, or to help in calculating some data or writing a scientific paper, etc. I am sure this definitely had a part in my decision to study first botany and then agronomy. Of course, my inability to fathom mathematics probably played a bigger part in it than all this. NARI has seen a lot of changes since its inception. During the initial years, the focus was on breeding of different crops for improvement in their yield and different characteristics. Also, agronomic investigations were carried out to find out the best practices for growing a given crop. This type of work has continued till today, but became restricted to fewer and fewer crops and finally focused only on safflower and sweet sorghum. My father was one of the pioneers in the early 1960s in starting the seed industry in India with the help of the Rockefeller Foundation. And early on he recognized the need for research in crop breeding and agronomy. That is how NARI was born as a division of Nimbkar Seeds. He has, however, had a penchant for novelty, and therefore NARI ended up carrying out research in a large number of yield crops, and since 1990 also in small ruminants. The animal husbandry division started by my father has been carrying out R&D on small ruminants very successfully under the leadership of my sister Chanda. Of course, the type of widespread success achieved in cotton and sorghum in the 1970s could not be duplicated later on, but the potential is now seen to be there for doing the same thing in sheep and goats. The renewable energy research started in the early 1980s and has been ably guided by Anil since then. His work has been a great source of inspiration to young people all over the world. He travels to many colleges, including the IITs, and gives lectures there. This affects so many students in such a profound manner that they continue to write to him after many years, describing the manner in which his short interaction with them affected their course of life. One of the major differences in the way of doing research 40 to 50 years ago and today, I feel, is ease of communication. Earlier, it was quite difficult to keep up to date regarding what was going on around the world. Now you can find out about the details of research on any topic literally within seconds, and even correspond with the authors regarding the current status even before publication. This is especially a boon for small institutions like us who are situated in isolated rural places. However, in earlier times, ignorance was bliss. You kept on doing your work oblivious to what was going on in the world, which often resulted in greater productivity of research than today, I feel. It so happens that this completion of 50 years will be one of the turning points in the history of NARI, as both our major research programs, one in safflower and the other in sweet sorghum, are being terminated. As the newer pay commissions continue to be established and the salaries keep on going through the roof, the amount being allotted to research expenses has not kept pace with them. It is now no more than 6 to 8% of the total sanctioned amount, with 92 to 94% going towards pay and allowances. We have therefore decided to terminate the government-funded coordinated centers on these two crops, unless they allow us to spend 20 to 25% of the total funds on research expenses. Since the chances of ICAR agreeing to this are slim, our work in these areas will ultimately cease. Therefore, we have several options which can be explored for future. We will have to generate our own research funds, get some help from the corporates, or explore funding opportunities for ad hoc projects from the government agencies, such as the TST. We hope to have some brainstorming post-lunch today and expect to get good suggestions from many of you in attendance today. Some of the future projects which we hope to carry out will be related to soil conservation. Soil erosion is a serious problem in the Deccan tracts of West Central India, and we wish to explore ways and means of reducing it by increasing awareness among farmers about practices such as minimum or no tillage, growing of cover crops, and establishing pastures using perennial grasses and legumes. Finally, once again, I would like to thank all the persons responsible for making it possible for NARI to become 50 years old. We will always remain indebted to them. And I thank everybody who has been responsible for our journey. Thank you.